late. I'm sorry.
How are you today?
Better than last night.
Well, I can agree on that.
Well, hello, Max.
Good afternoon, Mrs. Rutledge.
Got a table for us?
Certainly, madam. This way, please.
I'll have a scotch, mister.
Yes, sir.
A scotch and plain water.
Yes, sir.
Well, how'd you happen to pick out this place?
Maybe I wanted to hold your hand.
Oh, that can be arranged. What do you want to see me about?
Well, one thing. My father was very pleased when he saw the morning papers. So was I.
Yes, we were lucky. I managed to keep the Sternwoods out of it.
He hopes you didn't involve yourself too deeply.
You tell him it was no fault of yours?
No. He asked me to give you a check.
Well, I don't need any money yet.
He considers the case closed.
Oh?
It is, isn't it?
Well, as far as Geiger's concerned, yes.
Then it's completely closed. I hope this is satisfactory.
500? Well, that's a lot more than I expected, but welcome just the same.
We're very grateful to you, Mr. Marlowe, and I'm very glad it's all over. Tell me, what do you usually do when you're not working?
Play the horses, fool around.
No women?
Well, I'm generally working on something most of the time.
Could that be stretched to include me?
Well, I like you. I told you that before.
I liked hearing you say it. But you didn't do much about it.
Well, neither did you.
Well, speaking of horses, I like to play them myself. But I like to see them work out a little first. See if they're front runners or come from behind. Find out what their whole card is. What makes them run.
Find out mine?
I think so.
Go ahead.
I'd say you don't like to be rated. You like to get out in front. Open up a lead, take a little breather in the back stretch, and then come home free.
You don't like to be rated yourself.
I haven't met anyone yet that could do it. Any suggestions?
Well, I can't tell till I've seen you over a distance of ground. You've got a touch of class, but, I don't know how far you can go.
A lot depends on who's in the saddle. Go ahead, Marlowe. I like the way you work. In case you don't know it, you're doing all right.
There's one thing I can't figure out.
What makes me run?
Uh-huh.
I'll give you a little hint. Sugar won't work. It's been tried.
Well, what'd you try it on me for? Who told you to sugar me off this case? Was it Eddie Mars? All right. Don't answer me. Somebody put you up to it, and it wasn't your father. He didn't tell you to pay me off, did he?
No, he's not well. I used my own judgment.
Are you sure?
Of course I know it hasn't worked so well up till now.
What's Eddie Mars got to do with this case?
Nothing. He runs a gambling house. I play horses, I play the wheel.
Playing something else, too.
What makes
Never
you
mind
think
talking. Let me do it. Did you know it was Eddie Mars' blonde wife, Sean Regan, was supposed to run off with?
Who doesn't?
Did you know he owned the house Geiger operated in, that he was mixed up in that racket, too?
No, I don't believe
it. Then why does it bother you so much? What's Eddie Mars got on you? Oh, come now, Angel. Stop shaking. I don't want to hurt you. I'm trying to help you. Well, you better run along. But you made a deal and you're going to stick to it, right or wrong. We'll take up the question of you and I when the race is over. The only trouble is we could have...
Pardon me.
Yes. The only trouble is we could have had a lot of fun if you weren't a detective.
We still can.
So long.
Oh, well.